Hello my dear kids, welcome back to your English class. Today we are going to continue with the activities of the chapter The Fox and the Rabbit from your reading comprehension worksheet chapter 3 page 5 to 6. I hope my kids have already read the chapter and learned the new words. Did you? Yes? Very good. So shall we move on to the first activity? Okay, so moving on to the first activity page 5 is write the opposites. You have two words given there. Okay, the first word is behind and the second word fast. You have to write the opposite word of the behind and fast. Okay, now tell me what will be the opposite word of behind. Behind means when the teacher tell you please stand behind Chris. So what is the meaning of behind? To stand back of Chris, isn't it? So what will be the opposite of behind? In front. What is it? In front. Yes. Now fast. Fast means the fox ran fast as he could, isn't it? So what will be the opposite of fast? How does the turtle walk? The turtle walk slowly, isn't it? So fast opposite slow. Okay, so these are the two answers we are going to write here. Please see that you write very neatly using your pencil. Okay, so first answer, behind, opposite, in front, I N F R O N T, in front. Second word, fast, fast opposite, slow, S L O W, slow. Okay, so please see that you write very neatly and write and learn these two opposites in your rough book. Okay, yes. We are moving on to the next page, page 6. The next activity is write the past tense. Past tense means the things which has already happened. Okay, so most of the past tense, not all the past tense, most of them will end with ed. Okay, so what we are going to do here is I have given three words. Okay, we have to change these words into past tense. For that we have to add ed at the end of the word given here. Okay, so we shall see the first one. See the first one. The first word is race, R A C E. Here see that the word itself is ending with E, isn't it? So in order to change the word into past tense, we said that we have to add ED at the end, isn't it? But here see the word itself is ending with E. But so in that case, what we have to do is we don't need to add E again. Instead just add D. Okay, so if the word itself is ending with E and we need to change the word into past tense, don't repeat E again, just add D with it. Okay, so we'll see the first one how to do it. Race. We are going to change the word race into past tense by adding ED. So here the word is starting with R A C E. As the word itself is ending with E, we are only adding D at the end. Okay, now the word has become past tense, raised. Next one, chase, C H A S E is chase. Chase past tense, again we are going to add ED, C H A S E, just add D with it. Okay, next, call. Here it is ending with double L. So what we have to do? We have to add ED. C A L L E D. Okay. So I hope it is clear. If we want to change the words into past tense, okay, in this case, we have to add ED. Okay. Not all the past tense, most of the past tense are ending with ED. So here we are just learning about the past tense that ends with ED. Okay, in grade 2 we are only learning about the past tense that ends with ED. So here we have three words, R A C E, race, C-H-A-S-E, chase, and C-A-L-L, call. As the first two words are ending with E, we just need to add D with it to change the word into past tense. And the last one, it's ending with double L, so we have to add ED to change the word into past tense. So we wrote C-A-L-L-E-D. Okay? So I hope it is clear for you. Now we are moving on to the last activity, that is answer the following. We have four question answers. We are going to read one by one. In order to write the question answer, you have to be thorough with the passage. You have to be thorough with the story. So if you have not read the chapter, please read it before you write the answer. Okay? So we are moving on to the first question. Question number one. Who hid behind a tree? I repeat, who hid behind a tree? Who was hiding behind the tree, children? Yes, the rabbit, isn't it? When the fox chased the rabbit, the rabbit hid behind a tree, isn't it? The rabbit was hiding behind a tree. So who hid behind the tree? The rabbit hid behind a tree. So we are going to write the answer. Please see that you write very neatly. Start with the, T, H, H, E, the, rabbit, R, A, B, B, I, T, rabbit, hid, H, I, D, H, I, D, hid, behind, B, E, H, I, N, D, behind a tree, A, tree, T, R, E, E, tree, full stop. Okay, so the answer is the rabbit hid behind a tree. Okay, so next question, who was hungry? Who was hungry? Who was chasing the rabbit? Yes, the fox was chasing the rabbit because he was very hungry, isn't it? So who was hungry? The fox was hungry. So the answer is, please write down the, T-H-E, the fox, F, O, X, fox, was, W, A, S, was hungry, H, U, N, G, R, Y, hungry, full stop. Okay, now the third question, what was at the beehive when the fox chased towards the rabbit, towards the beehive? What was there? Was there rabbit near the beehive? No, isn't it? What was there instead of rabbit? There was the swarm of bees. The group of bees was there on the beehive, isn't it? So the answer is the swarm of bees was at the beehive. Okay, so we are going to write the answer. The, T-H-E, the swarm, S-W-A-R, M, swarm of, O-F, bees, B-E-E-S, bees, was, W-A-S, was at, A-T, at the, T-H-E, the beehive, B-E-E-H-I-V-E, full stop. Okay, so what was at the beehive? The swarm of bees was at the beehive. Moving on to the last question, what did the bees do when the fox ran towards the beehive? What did the bees do? The bees attacked him, isn't it? The bees were buzzing right behind him. The fox ran as fast as he could and the bees was chasing the fox by buzzing behind him, isn't it? So the answer will be the bees were buzzing right behind the fox. Okay, so we are going to write the answer. The, T-H-E, the bees, B-E-E-S, the bees were, W-E-R-E, were buzzing, B-U-E-Z-Z-I-N-G, buzzing, right R I G H T, right? Behind the fox, B E H I N D, the T H E, the fox, F O X, fox. Okay, so the answer is the bees were buzzing right behind the fox. Okay, so with this we have come to the end of the chapter, the fox and the rabbit. Hope the activities what we have done is clear. The first activity what we did is we wrote the opposites of two words given there, and then we wrote the past tense, okay, by adding ed to the word. Okay, past tense that ends with ed. Then we wrote the four question answers. So I want everybody to write and learn the new words and opposites, and see that you complete the activities. You write the question answers very neatly using your pencils, leaving one finger space. Okay, and read the chapter at least 3 times. Okay, with this we have come to the end. I hope the chapter was very clear and interesting for you. So we shall see with a new chapter the next video. Till then, take care. Bye.